Hello everyone. Today I'd like to talk about a gathering problem by autonomous mobile robots. This slide shows an outline of my talk. My presentation consists of six parts. First, I'll give some background information on autonomous mobile robots. Next, I'd like to describe the basic model of the robot. After that, I'll describe a more powerful model with light. In part 4 and 5, I'll give two algorithms to solve the gathering problem by robots with light. Finally, I'll finish with a brief conclusion. Let me start with autonomous mobile robots. Distributed autonomous mobile robots are a system which solves problems with multiple robots. They calculate on their own and cooperate. In this system, many problems are considered. For example, a circular formation problem is that scattered robots make a circular arrangement. And a gathering problem is that robots gather at a point. We consider the gathering problem in this research. Next, let me talk about the purpose of this research. There is a basic model proposed in previous research. Also, there are models having additional capabilities. So, what we purpose is that we reveal minimum capability to solve the gathering problem. I'll give two algorithms. The first one is the simulation algorithm. In previous research, any algorithms using k-colors in Async are simulated by Async robots using 5k colors. I'll talk about the detail of Async and Async in the next section. On the other hand, I give the algorithm using 3k colors, but it simulates restricted Async algorithm. We can adapt our simulation algorithm to the gathering problem. As a result, the number of colors used to solve the problem was reduced from 10 to 6. The second algorithm further reduces the number of colors from 6 to 3. Now, I want to go on to section 2 and focus on the basic model of autonomous mobile robots. The basic model is commonly called overload. There are some features. First, it doesn't have uniqueness. So these robots have the same capability and can't distinguish. Second, it doesn't have the capability of direct communication. Therefore, they move by observing the other robot's position. Third, they don't have persistent memory. They can't memorize used route and previous observed information. Finally, real robots have volume, but we consider robots as a point for simplicity. So robots may be in the same place. Each robot has a local coordinate system. It may be different from what others have. Since we consider robots as a point, robots have a two-dimensional coordinate system. Therefore, the x and y axis may be tilted in each. And the positive and negative directions of the x and y axis may be different in each. Also, I show now additional capability called chirality. It guarantees agreement of clockwise or counterclockwise. We use it in our algorithm. Robots execute three operations in a cycle. In look operation, it observes surrounding robots. In compute operation, it calculates its destination based on observing information. Finally, in move operation, it moves to its destination. Robot execute these three operations repeatedly. And the robot's movement has two types. Legit is that robots always reach their destination. On the other hand, non-legit is that robots don't always reach their destination. But they can move at least delta that is more than zero. Its value is unknown to them. In this research, we only consider under non-legit movement. Next, I'd like to look at schedulers. There are three types. Here you see the upper left figure of Async. R1 to R4 denote four robots, and L is look operation, C is compute operation, M is move operation. This figure shows that all robots execute operations at the same time. It is Async. And the cycle of LCM is called round. Next, Async is that not all robots always are activated in each round, but activated robots execute operations at the same time. Finally, Async is not synchronous, and the timing of operations is all over the place. Async, Async, and Async have fairness. The fair scheduler is that all robots are activated infinitely often. It means when a robot was activated, the robot will have a timing of activation. Next, I'd like to remind you of restricted Async I showed you in the results of our simulation algorithm. Restricted means unfair. Unfair scheduler is that not all robots are activated infinitely often, but there are always one or more enabled robots which move or change their color in a configuration. And the scheduler guarantees that at least one enabled robot is activated. Because it is not fair, there may be a robot which is not activated. I talked about basic model and a few things for using our research. In this slide, I'd like to talk about the gathering problem. Its goal is that all robots at any position gather at a point where they didn't know before. Previous research showed a theorem. Gathering problem can be solved in Fsync, but can't be solved in Async and Async. So, to solve gathering in Async and Async, we must use a more powerful model. In the next section, I'll show you a more powerful model having light. The model of robot with light is called Lumi. Some research calls it full light. In Lumi, the robot have lights and can know its state and surrounding robot state. The robot can change its color of light after executing compute operation and remain light's color unless it changes itself. This slide shows the results of previous research. First, what DAS showed was that Async algorithm using K colors can be simulated by using 5K colors. Next is the results of gathering problem in the models I talked about. In the basic model of ROT, I said that it could only solve in Async. In Lumi, there is the Async algorithm using two colors with rigid movement. But it requires a strong restriction, which is compute and move operation instantly. And Terai showed the gathering algorithm using two colors in Async with non-rigid movement and agreement chirality. Chirality means that robots agree clockwise or counterclockwise. By using the results and the simulation, we can get Async algorithm using 10 colors with non-rigid movement. So we improved this result. Now, the results of our research, let me start with the simulation algorithm. It simulates any unfair async using K colors by async robots with 3K colors. We reduced the number of colors, but it works in an unfair scheduler. And the figure below shows the transition of the configuration. We named three colors of light for control, S, M, and E. When all robots have S, activated enabled robots execute the algorithm in unfair async and change its color to M. If there is a robot having M, robots change M. Eventually, all robots have M. And after that, in a similar way, all robots have E. This is a cycle of the algorithm which works the same as one round in unfair async. I'm going to go into some detail about how the simulation works. At first, I'd like to remind you of unfair meaning. Unfair means that at least one robot is activated in a configuration. And since we consider in async, moving robots in a cycle must look at the same configuration. Here you see the figure. It is an example of simulation of an algorithm in unfair async. R1 to R4 denote 4 robots, and let R1, R3, and R4 be enabled robots. Red areas are S, green ones are M, and yellow ones are E. Here you focus on this. All robots have S. Since R1 and R4 are enabled robots and look at the same configuration, they'll change their color to M and move following a simulated algorithm. However, even if R2 looks at the configuration that all robots have S, R2 does nothing because R2 is not enabled robot. Therefore, in a cycle, one or more enabled robots execute a simulated algorithm and they observe the same configuration. After that, since R1 changed its color to M, robots executing look operation change its color to M. So eventually, all robots have M. When all robots have M, the configuration becomes that all robots have E. And finally, the configuration goes back to S. In a cycle, since one or more enabled robots observing the same configuration execute a simulated algorithm, we can say that it works in the same as one round in unfair async. The simulation of the example is the same as this schedule in unfair async shown below figure. The figure shows that there is an enabled robot which hasn't been activated. In the next cycle, the simulation algorithm doesn't guarantee that it will activate, and so it simulates unfair async scheduler, not async. Next, the simulation adapts the gathering algorithm, but previous research considers gathering algorithm in async. So we must reveal that the gathering algorithm works in unfair async. I'll talk about the previous algorithm in async. Gathering algorithm is divided into two sub-algorithms, from any initial configuration to onLDS and from onLDS to gathering. OnLDS means the configuration that robots are on a straight line. In previous research, it uses one color and agreement chirality from any initial configuration to onLDS. And it uses two colors from onLDS to gather. And therefore, the gathering algorithm uses two colors and chirality. We'll show that the gathering algorithm in async works in unfair async. In an async algorithm, if there is a monotonically decreasing potential function until the purpose is achieved, it works in unfair async. We can construct the potential function of the gathering algorithm in async, but time is limited, so I'll skip the detail of the potential function. And then, we obtain this table. In the previous simulation, the number of colors is multiplied by 5. But in our simulation, the number of colors is multiplied by 3. So from any initial configuration to OLDS, since 1 times 3 is 3, it uses 3 colors and chirality. From OLDS to gathering, since 2 times 3 is 6, it uses 6 colors. And therefore, we obtain the results of 6 colors and chirality. We reduce the number of colors than the previous result. Next section, we further reduce the number of colors from OLDS to gathering. It uses 3 colors. Let me go on to our second algorithm. I show you that it is solved by using 3 colors from OLDS to gathering. In this algorithm, the configuration transitions in this figure. It is the same transition as the simulation I proposed before. But when all robots have S, it is the only case of robots on 2 points. The cycle starts 2 points of S, and robots change their color to M and move to midpoint. Next, if only 1 point has S, they make break out of the cycle and gather. Then, robots change their color to E. Then, if only 1 point has E, they may break out of the cycle. Finally, all robots have E, and if there are more than 2 points, they break out of the cycle. And the configuration goes back to 2 points of S. In a cycle, distance of the line segment is shorter. So eventually, endpoints get close enough to gather even if the cycle is repeated. I think that you have a question. Can it successfully switch from the simulation algorithm to this algorithm? It's no problem. Because both algorithms work based on the same transition. When the configuration becomes OLDS by simulation, there are one or more M. Because there is a robot which changes its color to M and moves to make OLDS. Therefore, its simulation is either 1, 2, or 3. And after making OLDS, since the gathering algorithm works in the same cycle, the configuration is 2 points of S or gather. I showed that from OLDS to gathering is solved by using 3 colors, and the switch from the simulation is possible. Therefore, the gathering problem can be solved by using 3 colors and agreement chirality. I want to finish with a summary. Our results indicate the following. First, what we showed was that unfair sync algorithm using k colors is simulated by using 3k colors. Next, we defined the monotonically decreasing potential function of the gathering algorithm in SSYNC. So we can adapt our simulation for gathering and get the results of 6 colors and chirality. We further reduced the colors from 6 to 3 by combining our simulation and one more algorithm. The open problem is what's the minimum number of colors with non-rigid in SSYNC is. Since gathering for 2 robots needs 2 colors, we estimate that the gathering problem needs 3 colors at least. And that's all for my presentation. Thank you.